Building a college list is actually one of my favorite things to do with students, but it is one of the more time-consuming parts of the college admissions process. With literally thousands of colleges and universities in the United States, it's hard to know where to even start. But there are ways to stay organized throughout the process and make things a little less demanding, and I've got some tips to help. If you're ready to start building your college list, hit that like button and let's get started. Hey there, my name is Carly, and this channel is for college-bound high school students who want support and advice around all things college admissions. We're gonna jump right into these tips. One of the first things I recommend to students is to start searching early. And by searching early, I mean dabble in your options. See what's out there. It doesn't hurt to walk around your local college campus or maybe even stop by a college on a road trip. It doesn't have to be anything formal or extensive. I know things are a little different right now, so be sure to check a college's policies or guidelines on if guests are allowed on campus right now, their mask policy, just so you're being respectful of the students, staff, and faculty on that campus. These brief experiences, even though it doesn't seem like it, may actually help you when it comes to what I consider the first official step of starting your college list. Okay, first thing you need to do before starting your college list is determining some criteria. There are probably hundreds of factors to consider when selecting colleges to put on your list. When I word it like that, it's a little overwhelming, right? Here's an activity to reduce that overwhelm. Start with a whiteboard, a giant piece of paper, or even a couple post-it notes. Throw those post-it notes, throw that piece of paper up on the wall, and create three sections or headers. Must have, might be nice, and absolutely not. Then start adding criteria under each appropriate header. Maybe you want to attend a more conservative or liberal-leaning college. Maybe you want to attend a school with a religious affiliation. Do you like snow, or are you looking for 350 days of sunshine? Do you want to do undergraduate research? What about living on campus? There are so many different pieces to think about, but once you get started, you'll probably find yourself snowballing through a lot of different options. Before you know it, you'll have a ton of criteria up on the wall to help you navigate your search. Another thing to keep in mind when building your college list is to keep an open mind. One of my favorite scenarios is when a student selects a college either just to put on their list or maybe it's their final selection that they had never heard of before or never would have imagined choosing. Students with an open mind during the college search process can rationally decide what kind of schools are going to be the best fit for them. I strongly encourage you not to restrict your search just to the schools that you've heard of or that your friends or siblings have attended or even the ones that your parents went to. There are a lot of great options out there and one of them could be the school for you and you've just never heard of it, but it is a fantastic school. Some students are looking for that name brand and it just might not be the right fit for you. One of the most important steps is to do a little bit of research in the financial aid area. You might be eligible for need-based aid or maybe you're focusing more on merit aid. Whatever you're looking for, do your research ahead of time. This includes working with your family to calculate your EFC. Your EFC is your expected family contribution. Once you have an idea of what your EFC is, you can specifically target schools that are going to either meet that need or come close to it, or maybe ones that are specifically offering merit aid that you may be eligible for. The last important piece when it comes to building your college list is categorizing and prioritizing. This part comes when you have anywhere from 15 to 25 schools on your list. Categorizing is going to help you determine your chance of admission to a particular school. This is research spent comparing your academic profile to the academic profile of students being admitted to a specific school. Are you above the median scores? Then you might have an above average chance of being admitted to that school. Focus on standardized test scores if applicable and GPA first, and that'll give you a better picture of your chance of admission. Now, prioritizing. Prioritizing can be done at the beginning once you've established your list of 15 to 25 schools and then multiple times throughout your junior year or basically up until you're applying to schools. If you're building your list at the beginning of your senior year, you may only have time to prioritize once or twice before you end up applying. It's important to understand that you are going to grow through this process and your list is going to change, and that's exactly what it's meant to do. Prioritization is going to change based on the more that you research and learn about each school. Schools might be knocked off the list, schools that are at the top might move to the bottom and vice versa. It might be that you do further research on your very top choice and then you decide, that might not be the school for me. Let's bump it down a couple notches. Honestly, this shows that you are committed and engaged to the process and it's totally okay and expected for your list to change. Once your college list is built, categorized, you're going to be doing some ongoing prioritization, then it's time to narrow it down. I'm going to be talking about narrowing down your college list in my next video, so don't forget to hit that subscribe button.